here's the discovery. The discovery is that the theory of everything, the solution to Einstein's problem, the solution to unifying the material and the immaterial, the subjective and the objective, the left and the right, the dualistic aspect of the universe, this knowledge is the oldest knowledge in the universe. And this knowledge gives the individual the power to create their reality. This knowledge gives the individual the power to tap into that infinite energy in the self, to tap into that oneness. Like I said before, with the example of the drop in the ocean, the individual is just a drop in the massive ocean. And if the individual can tap into that ocean, they can manifest everything. They can have access to this infinite energy source, and they'll be able to manifest anything, right? And in essence, because man is energy himself, man is himself a god, and with that, man can create his reality, right? And with my studies, I realized that with the fall and the collapse of the ancient African empires, that all the way to the Egyptian Empire, that's the most recent one that we are familiar with today, that the remnants of their existence remain somewhat intact today, 6,000-7,000 years, 12,000 years later, is that this sort of school of thought was the school of thought that persisted on planet Earth prior to the existence of the Abrahamic religions. And what I realized was that this sort of ancient African ideology that existed pre-Christianity, pre-Judaism, pre-Islam, which are all Abrahamic religions, and all these religions are just reinterpretations of this original story, original laws of the universe. So the ancient Africans weren't religious. Pre-colonialism, they were not religious. They understood already that they themselves were energy beings that had the ability to harness this energy and manifest their reality, right? And what happened with the Abrahamic religions, which include Judaism, Christianity, and Islam, it's like these religions, what they did was they came to the person, and instead of telling the person that you are in fact an energy being, you're a god, and because of this energy in you that you're made of, you have the ability to harness the infinite energy of the universe and create your entire existence. They came and told people that no, you in fact are different from yourself, which is that God. You are different from consciousness. You are different from this infinite energy. And to access this infinite energy, you have to go through the church. You have to go through some sort of ritual. You have to go through sacrifice. Something is in a way. I realized that this was a way of hijacking this energy that these beings possessed, right? So if every human, every being is an energy being, and every being has the innate ability to access this infinite power within them, to access infinite energy and create this universe, right? To manifest this universe, because we are energy beings. If someone is able to convince you that you're not, and they're able to utilize you, then that means that person essentially is able to enslave you and use you for your energy for as long as you remain unaware of who you are.